What do we know about the YouTube search algorithm in 2020? Today, let's look at what it is, how it works under the hood, and also how we can trigger it so that we can get more views via the YouTube search algorithm. All right, let's get started with number one. What is it? I mean, you all know already, right? On YouTube, we have the search here, and ideally, we want our videos to rank high. And the added benefit of YouTube search, we will later learn how to trigger it. If you rank your videos in search, then the likelihood is very high that the video also ranks in Google search as well. Here, for example, I managed to rank my own video at the top spot. And also on Google search, look at that, same search term, we have a video carousel here where my own video appears as well. So if you apply YouTube SEO, like we will learn later, then your video will not only rank in YouTube search, but also with a high chance in Google search as the cherry on top. All right, to understand how we get more views via the search algorithm, we need to know how the algorithm works under the hood. The most important aspect to know is that the search algorithm, by default, let's look here, I expanded the filter, sorts the videos by relevance. So the most relevant videos appear at the top here. The big question is, however, what is relevance? If we have a look at the Morningfame keyword research tool, here we are looking at the search term click-through rate YouTube, like we did before on YouTube. We can see with the yellow markers here that this search term appears in the title and in the description in part in all those videos that rank here. These yellow markings that you see here are all aspects of increasing the relevance of a video for that particular search term. Basically, if a viewer goes to YouTube search and types into the search bar, in this case, click-through rate YouTube, well, then the search algorithm takes this search term and looks into the archive of all the videos on YouTube. And then it picks all the videos that have the search term in their title, description, and tags. But this is, of course, not the full story. You can imagine for a particular search term, like in this case, click-through rate YouTube, there are so many different videos on YouTube that there is not enough space for all of those videos that are relevant for this search term to all rank high. I mean, there are only a given spots to rank videos, right? So YouTube, the search algorithm, has to pick those videos that are not only relevant, optimized for the particular search term, but also are the best videos of all the relevant videos. And the best videos is a combination of multiple factors. This is first a boost that each new video gets just because it is new, usually in the first week of the video. And then the click-through rate, which is mostly the thumbnail, and the watch time that the video gets. If people are watching the video to the end, well then this is a good signal for the YouTube search algorithm, plus the other signals that I mentioned in the beginning, to rank the video quite high in the search results. This is basically all there is to it for the search algorithm, but don't forget one tiny aspect. These search results are also a little bit customized to the viewing behavior of that particular viewer. So each viewer on YouTube, even though they might type the same search term into the search bar, right, they will see a little bit of different search results because there is a little customization for the particular viewer in place. And that is so important to know, not because when we want to rank in search that we have to consider this. Forget about that. We will ignore that when we talk about how to get your videos rank high in search. But it is important to know because if you are checking whether your video ranks in search, then this customization plays a role, making it look like your videos rank high, but in reality, they don't rank high because you, as your creator, all the times your videos appear to rank higher than they usually do. So when you look up your own videos in the search results in order to see if you rank there, then make sure that you have an incognito window in which you do the YouTube search and not while you're logged in with your own account, because you don't want this customization to happen and then think like your video appears in position one or two of the search results, whereas in reality, usually across all the different viewers on YouTube, your video usually ranks lower than it appears for you. So use an incognito window when you are checking your own rankings. But aside from that, let's sum up. Relevance is important, the boost for a new video, click-through rate and watch time. So a good video plus the SEO, and that leads us into the part, how do you rank high in search? How to get more views from the search algorithm? Okay, the first half is to optimize your title, description and tags for relevance. We learned the search algorithm sorts the videos by relevance, so this part has to be spot on. And the relevance you do right, let's look at the Morningfame keyword research tool to make it visual for you. For example, I had a video that is about video description YouTube. That is a search term for which I wanna rank. Yeah. So if people enter video description YouTube into the search bar, then my video should show up. So I optimized the title around it. Here we have the search term in the title, a little bit intriguing element at the end so that more people click. But anyway, this yellow part here, marked yellow part, is the important part for the search algorithm, for the machine. And then we have the description in which I also included this search term in there. As you see here below, it is marked in yellow that I have it included in there as well. This is also what the search algorithm, this robot, looks at when it decides whether your video is relevant for a given search term or not. And then finally, we of course have the tags where we have the main search term and related ones, right? Video description box on YouTube, YouTube video description tips, all that. Search terms, basically, that people also could enter into the search bar that evolve around the same topic that your video is about. So the purpose is to explain the search algorithm, what is the topic of your video? And once the search algorithm knows the topic of your video, then it also knows for which search terms to rank your video. And that is the whole approach with the relevance, yeah? We explain with one only target search term that we optimize our video for. In this case here, this is the main target search term. We include it into the description, the title and the tags. But also, of course, we want to rank for related search terms as well. And that happens, first of all, by including more related search terms into the tags and, very important, into the description. When you look here in the Morningfame keyword research tool, you can click highlight tags. And then in the pink underlines, you see additional search terms that are included into the text. Very important that it's still a human readable text, but the machine will analyze this text in your description for additional search terms. Yeah, like here, how to write a YouTube description, for example. And these I took from the tags because, first of all, we collect different search terms that all evolve around the same video topic, and then we can weave in a few more of them into the description. And with that, we give the YouTube search algorithm a pretty good understanding of the video topic. And with this, the search algorithm can decide where to rank your videos. By the way, even for other search terms that you didn't include into the description, tags and title, it can analyze it, understand the video topic and then rank your video even for search terms you didn't think of before. So don't worry about that part. However, if we have this highly relevant metadata, right? I mean, here in the tool, for example, it's evaluating the metadata that entered into the tool and it gives me an A grade. I really did a great job. But this is only one half of the SEO process, the optimization process in order to rank our videos high in the search results. Usually we only think about this part, but there is a second half that is maybe even more important than just getting the metadata right. And that other half is the competition. For example, here we have in the keyword tool as well, by the way, for that to understand, you actually need a tool that gives you the competition for a particular search term. But in any way, just for your understanding, yeah, in Morningfame, for example, these four grades here are the way how it tells you the competition for the search term that we just entered into the search bar. And here you can see with the red grades, it's telling the user of the tool that this search term is too competitive. Back then, I tried to optimize this video for the search term, taking a chance. It was a little too competitive for me to rank. And unfortunately, that was a bad idea. You see here, I got bad grades. I would have known that I have low chances to rank. And in the end, I didn't rank. So what we need to do, and that is really the most critical point to make your optimization work, is to find search terms that have low enough competition. Low enough, by the way, for the size of your channel. Yeah, a small channel has to have a search term, focus on a search term that has very low competition. A larger channel can rank for search terms that have even higher competition because the large channel in itself is already large. So this is very important when you look at competition, it has to be low enough for your channel. And the result of that is then if you have a low enough competition search term that you optimize around, create great metadata for that, so highly relevant metadata as I showed you before, then you have a good chance to rank. So as you see, we are already talking about how to rank your videos higher in search with the understanding how the search algorithm works. And since it is so important to have search terms with low enough competition, how do you find those search terms? There are many different techniques to discover those search terms, but one very common one is, for example, to look for long tail search terms, which usually have less competition. And when we look here at the video description YouTube, for example, this is a search term that it is a little bit too competitive for my channel still. I just enter a space. By the way, you can do the same on YouTube with the search bar there. And then you get these suggestions that you already know from YouTube. And here, for example, this is a longer search term, which is a little bit more in detail, YouTube video title and description. This one, as you see here, gives me better grades. That means in this case, when you know how Morningfame evaluates the competition, then you know that this means the competition is low enough for my channel to rank my videos. So making a video about YouTube video title and description would allow me to rank a video. Of course, as I said, there are many more techniques to find less competitive search terms. Just one example, for example, if I want to do a video about YouTube SEO, then I can use the alphabet method that I learned from Brian G. Johnson, really great method, where you enter a search term, YouTube SEO, and then you go through the alphabet, YouTube SEO A, B, C, D, and so on. And this way, I get all these recommendations here that are all inspiration about which search terms I could look up, check whether I could rank a video for these search terms. And if you want to equip your arsenal with more of those techniques, well then check out this video in which I explain each and every one in detail. All right, so search is a very dependable and the perfect way to rank your videos, get first views For small channels in particular, it's really the first algorithm that small channels should focus on because it is so dependable. And when you manage to do that, you slowly grow an audience. And with that, then other algorithms also start to promote your videos, bring your views. And that is in particular the home algorithm, where usually your subscribers come by, and also new visitors, new people that don't know about your channel yet. And then the third algorithm is suggested videos. That is, once you grow your channel to a larger size, also a very important view driver. Actually, if we combine all those algorithms, YouTube search, YouTube homepage, and the suggested videos algorithm, all together drive more than 75% of all the views all channels get, disregarding of which size the channel is. So if you focus your efforts on those three algorithms, search, home, and suggested videos, you are really well equipped to grow your YouTube channel. And since we talked about the search algorithm in this video, I made this same video like this one that introduces you to the other algorithms for the other two. So here is the home algorithm, aka browse features, and here is suggested videos. Cheers, my friends.